Hello everyone, I'm Kris Rottiers. I'm the CEO and co-founder of the company Dynsecu, and in this video I'll explain a little bit more about how our technology works. So we have created a recognizable instinctively authentication login technology, and actually with our technology the user has to program his profile one time, and afterwards he can log in by simply recognize the attributes and the recognition objects. If you want to know what that means, I will invite you to check our video about our demo. You will find a link in this video to our demo movie. And actually the recognition answers are so unique for every person that it's nearly impossible for a third person to log in via this system, because it's so cognitively bounded to the end user. Actually, the user don't have actively remember his own passwords or PIN codes, and he doesn't also need some special hardware of it. At any time, also the user, he wants to log in, he or she has only to recognize the valid answers challenges between the false challenges. So actually, what does that mean? The source algorithm behind the whole technology will always mix different challenges, false challenges, between the real challenges based on the user's previous login procedure. And it actually recognizes a little bit the user login attempts, and the whole procedure on it is based on it. Also, the algorithm will recognize some hack attempts and put automatically some challenges who are hacked in quarantine by the next login attempts of the user. And actually the whole technique is also based on rolling codes. What does that mean? That means that when a user wants to log in a first time, a second time, there will be other challenges mixed up, real challenges mixed up between false challenges. And also the various real challenges of the user are always spread across a different backend ID architecture. So it means that when challenge, for example, challenge 1 to 5 will be mixed up on server A, challenge 5 to 10 will be mixed up on server B, and challenge 10 to 15 will mix up on server C. We call it a little bit a little blockchain backend, so it becomes nearly impossible to hack the whole login procedure. And actually also the challenges are customizable. That means that when a challenge is hacked, or there is an attempt from hacking, the user is also has also the possibility to customize his whole procedure on one specific device, let's say for example a computer, for safety reasons. And also the login can be done by different kinds of user interfaces, let's say for example a voice user interface. So this is a little bit how our technology works, a short explanation, but if you have some questions, if you please contact me as CEO, co-founder of Dynsecu, and let's have a meeting, let's have a phone call. Don't hesitate to contact us or check our website www.dynsecu.com, and let's talk. I hope you enjoy this little explanation, and hear you guys. Thank you for your attention. Bye.